Hi, I'm April Kettelle, owner of Automated Shading and Lighting Control, and welcome to ASITV. Many clients come to us with a basic understanding of automation and control as it relates to their finished product. But we are regularly asked, what is the difference between a wired and a wireless system? And how do I know which one I need? When specifying wiring for a lighting control or motorized shading system, you must always give consideration to two key elements, power and communication. Depending on the system, these sometimes are accomplished from the same wiring or through two different sources. It's important to understand that when you hear the term wireless used, it does not mean that there is no wiring at all needed to achieve your automated products. Rather, it tends to mean that communication element does not require wiring. But it does not eliminate the need for wiring for power. Regardless of the system type, the device, processor, or shade will always require power at its location. The only exception here will be if you're looking at a battery-operated shade, but outside of this, you will always need some form of wiring to provide power to operate whatever you are controlling, a shade, a light, a keypad. Communication to your shade or device, however, can often be wireless through radio frequency networks and controls. This is what the term wireless actually refers to, the communication or control side. In the example of a motorized shade, the shade itself where the motor resides will always need power. However, a handheld remote or even a wall switch cut into the wall does not necessarily need direct wiring, but rather can be powered by a simple 3-volt battery and communicate to the shade through an RF signal that tells the shade when to move. There are several factors to review when determining if a wired or wireless control system is best for you, as it pertains to construction and control needs. However, some basic principles apply. A home or building at new construction, of course, has more options. Running wire from a control system should be done early in the electrical stages, so planning for this when drawings are being developed will allow you the ability to run wire for both power and communication prior to drywall and finishing. Running new wire once drywall is hung is not usually feasible, never mind unpleasant. At new construction, your communication wiring can be configured for either a wired or a wireless control system. With the reliability and advancement in RF networks, a project that, say, is less than 5,000 square feet, with a smaller number of devices, the capacity to work within the required RF transmission range, and no need for conditional programming, can often be just as well suited for a wireless system as wired. If you are already living in a completed home that is finished, a wired control system is almost always not feasible, and wireless control makes the most sense. It eliminates having to run several additional wires, eliminates construction demolition or extensive drywall repair that can be messy, time-consuming, and costly. We are simplifying a bit today on a much larger topic, but this is a good start to understanding the concept between wired and wireless control. For more information on one type of wireless RF network, check out our earlier episode on Lutron's ClearConnect technology. If you like this episode, let us know or send us any questions you have related to this topic. You may also subscribe to our YouTube channel or follow us on Facebook. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week with a new episode of ASITV. Tune in and learn more on controlling your light and transforming your space with shading and lighting control.